Hello friends, myself Ayush Sharma from Choice. We are going to discuss about the non-resident Indians, and in this video we will talk about the taxation of non-resident Indians. In the previous video we had discussed about the residential status, and this video will cover only the taxation of the non-resident Indian part. As per the income tax, two things are the primary deciding factors of the taxability of any income. First is the receipt, whether it is received in India or outside India. Second condition is the accrual, whether it is accrued in India or outside India. So these are the two primarily deciding factor of taxability of any income. We have mentioned the scenarios, whether it is received in India, outside India, accrued India, outside India, accrued outside India, received in India, and the taxability of the respective kind of assessees are mentioned here: resident, ordinary resident, resident, not ordinary resident, and non-resident. So the first condition is that income received or deemed to be received in India, whether earned in India or elsewhere. So that means any income which is first received in India, irrespective of the fact whether it is earned in India or outside India, will be taxed for all type of assessees, be it resident, ordinary resident, resident, not ordinary resident, and non-resident. The second condition is that income which accrues or arises or is deemed to accrue or arise in India during the previous year, whether received in India or outside India, that means accrued in India and received elsewhere outside India. So such income will again be taxed for all kind of assessees. That means any income which has been accrued in India will be taxed for all kind of assessees, irrespective of the fact whether it is received in or outside India. The third condition is income which accrues or arises outside India and received outside India from a business which is situated in India. That means that any income which is accrued and received both outside India or anything or out of those, but the business from which the income is generated is situated in India. So in that case, for the resident, it will be taxed because he is a resident of India. Resident but ordinary, not ordinary resident, again it will be taxed. This is as per the latest amendment by the Finance Act 2020. And for non-resident, it will not be taxed because it is accrues outside India and received outside India. So there is no linkage to India except the fact that the business is set up in India. But since because he is a non-resident, this income will be exempt for this particular assessee. Income which accrues or arises outside India or received outside India in the previous year from any other source. So this condition says that income has accrued outside India and received also outside India. So for resident assessee, it will be taxed. So it is important to note that anybody who is resident, so any income, whether it is received outside India, earned outside India, global income is taxed here. For the resident but not ordinary resident, this income will not be taxed, and non-resident will not be taxed because there is no linkage to India in this kind of scenarios. The last option, the last scenario is that income which accrues or arises outside India and received outside India during the preceding year, relevant previous year, and remitted to India during the relevant previous year. So that means any income which were earned in the previous financial year, or let's say preceding financial years, and received in the current financial year. So in that case, it will not be taxed for any kind of assessee, because for the resident it was taxed in the previous financial year, so therefore will not be taxed in the current financial year. For the resident, not ordinary resident, similar case will prevail, and for non-resident, since because there is no link to India, it will not be taxed. Let's talk about the taxability of the NRI for the foreign income. Any income which is received or deemed to be received in India, or accrued or deemed to be accrued in India, or arising or deemed to be arising in India, will be taxable in India. Okay, that means any income which is received or deemed to be received in India, or accrued or deemed to be accrued in India, or arising or deemed to be arising in India, such income shall be taxable in India. Let's talk about the taxability of income of NRI for the Indian incomes. Any Indian income from salary, so if the services are rendered in India, such salary income will be taxed in India, irrespective of the fact whether it is received in India, outside India, or elsewhere. This income will be taxed in India. rental income will be the taxability of the rental income will be at par with the resident SACs. A standard deduction of 30% will be given, and deduction for any principal repayment from the housing loan in India will be deducted from the income, and it will be taxed at the slab rates. The third is the capital gains. Capital gain for listed shares and units of equity mutual fund. For the long term capital gain up to 1 lakh, there is no taxation. More than 1 lakh rupees, where there is a holding period is more than 12 months, it tax rate is 10%. So any long term capital gain more than 1 lakh rupees, for where the holding period is more than 12 months, will be taxed as 10%. Any short term capital gain where the holding period is up to 12 months are taxed at the rate of 15%. This is for the NRI. Capital gains in case of unlisted shares, long term capital gain where the holding period is more than 24 months are taxed at the rate of 10%, and the short term capital gains are taxed at per the slab rates. Let's talk about the other common incomes, which are interest income on fixed deposit and savings accounts, which is held in Indian bank account, which is simply taxable in India because this is income accruing and arising in India. Interest on NRE and FCNR account is tax free because this is exempt. Interest on NRO account is fully taxable, and there is a withholding tax of 30% applicable in India. Interest on PPF is exempt, and dividend income is fully taxable on a gross basis, and the tax rate of 20% plus applicable surcharge and cess will be applicable. These are the slab rates applicable to NRIs for the assessment year 2021-22. Income up to 2,50,000 taxable income. Here we are talking about the taxable income. Up to 2,50,000 rupees is nil. 2,50,000 to 5 lakh rupees, 5% of the taxable income. This is 2.5 to 5 differential amount. We will be talking about those only. 5 lakh to 10 lakh rupees, 20% is the tax rate. Above 10 lakh rupees, 30% is the tax rate. So earlier there used to be 10% condition as well, but now that is removed. Health and education cess, which is 4% of the income tax. 4% of the income tax will be additionally charged. These are the surcharges where the income is more than 50 lakh rupees, 1 crore rupees, and 2 crore and 5 crore respectively. These rates will become applicable on the surcharge. Following are the deductions allowed to an NRI under section 80C. These are the this is as per the at par with the resident taxation for the NRIs as well. That maximum up to 1.5 lakh rupees deduction can be allowed. Life insurance premium are included in the 1.5 lakh condition. Children's tuition fees are included. Principal repayment on the loan for the house property which is situated in India is included. ULIPs, investment in ULIPs included, and investment in ELSS is included in that 1,50,000 under ATC. Other deductions, ATD available, ATE available, ATG available, and ATTA are available to an NRI. Investment in PPF is not allowed. That means an NRI cannot make new investments into PPF in India, but for those PPF accounts which were opened earlier and they maintained until they become the NRIs will be continue to be operational. So that's all for this current video. We will be talking about the type of bank accounts which an NRI can open and maintain in India in the next video. Thank you very much. Please do let us know if you have any questions in the comment section. Please do like and share this video and subscribe our channel. Thank you very much.